LD, aka the independent variable.
Trip God, I'm observing out the hallway. Hey, where the gold at, baby? Where the clothes at, baby? Hey, where the dough at, baby? In the bank, you know I ain't trying to blow that, baby. Hey, where you saying that money? Where you saying that money?
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies, you know who I'm talking to. It is episode number 29, 3.4 of the season. I am Michael Tull, owner of the Genitals. Wow. And I with me, I have the owner of the franchise, Mr. Victor Rodriguez.
How you doing, Michael? I know you wanted to say it was part of the franchise.
I almost did. It's borderline embarrassing. It really is. Well, we've got a lot to get to. Divisions have changed a little bit this week. We had a couple undefeateds. There is one undefeated left. Your defending champion, Mr. Mike Green, Goat Emoji, still leading the East undefeated. He does have Joe Tiger hot on his heels at 2-1, though. I took the fall. Victor took the fall. Nick's Kicks took the fall. Mike's the only one standing so far. So that's an update on your division so far. Victor, tell us what you got on the waiver wire. This commercial break is brought to you by Four Roses Bourbon. It's delicious.
So I'll go ahead and start with the perfect bid, which is worth to Chris Powell, $20 from Wayne Gallman. Michael Green also put in a bid for $20. I think it's good strategy whenever you're leading the pack to go ahead and get other pieces to avoid them picking that up. But I think that a couple guys missed it. Nick, who needed a running back. Slice, the guys needed a running back. Ainsley needed a running back. Pretty much everyone basically needs a running back.
I needed a running back, and I bid on him, but I just got him. IT, just fucking $20 for Wayne Gallman? For the dude that you've never heard of that's going to play for 4, maybe 8 weeks? What, really? I mean,
yeah, and I don't even think it's 8 weeks. It's Wayne. We don't even hear about him. I mean, it could be because Saquon does everything.
His name is Wayne. Like, Tigers probably got an uncle named Wayne, and he's a running back at the Giants. Wayne. It's not. I don't know.
But it's a running back, and that's the price they go for. You can see it's pretty much been the stock market in our league. We've seen a bunch of players, a lot of trades go down this week. So it's the price for a running back, I guess, if you look at the franchise and Nick's Kicks trade. And then you look at some running backs that went earlier today for a wide receiver and Amari Cooper. I don't know. Your thoughts on that trade?
On the Amari Cooper trade?
Yeah. Because I know me and you talked about wide receivers are a dime a dozen.
That's my thought, but yes, that is true, but that's probably only true in the backside of wide receivers. I mean, right? Like, your top 5 or 10 guys are not replaceable. And Amari Cooper right now is in that. So I don't think Mike made out bad, but
you don't think
AJ Green comes back. He's a top. Even a hurt A.J. Green's probably a top 15 guy, right? I mean, John Ross and Tyler Boyd right now are playing well, and A.J. Green's going to come back and fill that role. Melvin Gordon's reporting back, which is really the main reason that I'm drinking because, you know, it's my fucking fault. I mean, Billy won the trade, assuming Melvin Gordon plays well, assuming A.J. Green does come back, and he got James Conner. He got two starting running backs and a number one wide receiver for a number one wide receiver. Billy won the trade, in my opinion. Billy won the trade. Mike didn't make out bad.
I don't think he really made out. Like, what is he doing? He's the only undefeated team. Why change it? When you look at I'm glad it happened for the rest of the league because Amari Cooper plays Chicago in the playoffs. He also plays the Rams in the playoffs. And if Mike makes the championship, he plays Philadelphia. And at that time, week 16, Jason Garrett usually plays most of his starters in week 16. But the way that NFC East division is going, and Amari already getting nicked up, he had an MRI done today, precautionary. So I don't think Mike did what Mike was supposed to do to try and solidify himself as a back-to-back champion.
I'll let Mike talk about it, because I don't want to. Me and Mike had a conversation about it, and I want that conversation to remain between me and Mike. If he wants to share, there is more to that trade, and I mean like in terms of how it happened, got proposed, accepted. Mike felt like it was important to be a man of his word and do the trade, as opposed to flopping, you know, flipping on what he told Billy he would do at one time or another. Without really trying to share what Mike told me, it's not just on the surface. Mike said, "I want Amari Cooper. I'm going to give you these guys." There's more. There's a little more. There's a little more to it than that. So, if Mike wants to share, he listens to the show. He'll share. He'll be fine with that. I assume he will. But it's not just on the surface what it appears, at least.
Yeah, I mean, I get that. But whenever you're undefeated, though, just don't mess with it. But it is what it is, and we can see kind of a shift of, like, a few years ago, wide receivers was the thing to have. Back when Antonio Brown was going number one overall, we're way past Antonio Brown going number one overall now. You know about that little bit of AB. And he kind of ABC'd his way out of there.
Still drinking.
I got a bottle of Patron up there. Kind of make me want to go up there and grab it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Well, with all that depressing talk about Antonio Brown and Melvin Gordon, we're going to jump into the matchups for the week. First off, we're going to talk about my game against Pick of the Litter. I can't really pick it. As you know, I'm going to pick myself. I like what I got. I did pick up Kyle Allen this week. I don't know that I can really start him yet, but Houston has given up. I saw it today. Houston's given up like the 28th most. They give up a stupid amount of points to quarterbacks.
Yeah.
So it is a little bit of a sticky play because Matt Ryan hasn't been totally all there. Tennessee's defense is not awful. I don't know. I mean, I like my team, obviously. I believe I'm going to win the game. I need a running back. Anybody wants Antonio Brown, anything you want to give me, anything you want to give me, I will take. I mean, right. I see it through rose-colored glasses. It helps me that Nick Chubb's going against Baltimore. It probably helps me that I have Matt Ryan and he has Julio Jones. If Julio scores, I scored with Matt Ryan. Stephon Diggs is playing Chicago. His guys have poor matchups, in my opinion. So that helps me. But, Victor, you make the pick. Tell me what you think.
Well, Ainsley, he's got a lot of teams that's got a lot of question marks as far as players goes. Aaron Rodgers, I don't even think he's the QB1 right now. And Stephon Diggs, he's had 6 catches in 3 games. That's unheard
of. I'll trade you Antonio Brown for Stephon Diggs right now.
I would honestly probably take that deal if I was Ainsley, just so I don't have to play Stephon Diggs. It's probably safe for putting Stephon Diggs on the bench.
Yeah.
And so for that, yeah, it's probably a good idea for him to do it. Because right now, Stephon Diggs is hurting him more than AB's hurting you because he's not having to play him.
That's a great way to see it, in my opinion.
But I think this is a get-right game for Aaron Rodgers. For Ainsley, for him moving forward, I think that he needs Aaron Rodgers to do Aaron Rodgers things. But I think you win this. I think you have Christian McCaffrey, who is one of the elite running backs. And like we talked about earlier, there's not a lot of running backs producing right now. So I like you getting this win and taking control of that division. So, yeah, let's move on to the next one.
Next up, we have the franchise against Freddie Thrower Jr. Victor, you talk me around your team, and then I'll tell you what I think.
Well, I have Austin Eckler. It's probably been my last week enjoying that little nugget that I had.
That is true.
But I like my Patrick Mahomes. I do not like that Jaron is on the receiving of every one of those touchdowns that he could be throwing. So I had that natively going for me. But I do like my running backs. He does have the Ezekiel Elliott going against Saints. And I'm not quite sure how me and Jaron's going to battle back and forth. ESPN projections, don't ever pay attention to them. They had me winning by 20 points. I think it's going to actually be a lot closer than that. This is also, like I said earlier with Aaron Rodgers, this get-right game for Jared Goff. If he doesn't do anything, then he kind of needs to toss him to the wayside. But I think I can do it just because Patrick Mahomes, he's got a lot of weapons. He doesn't need Jaron's wide receivers. I hope he doesn't go that way this week. He's more of a Kelce Watkins this week. But I think I can cruise comfortably to a win. And then the side bet that me and Jaron has this week is one of us going to write a postcard and read it on social media, post it, and mail it to the other person so they can kind of have it as a trophy on display. And I like my trophies on display.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really disagree. I mean, you picked up Derrick Henry this week, which I just don't understand. But my opinion is different than other people's, I guess.
Well, we got a bunch of uncertainty at quarterback positions. I mean, you have to not look at names, look at the points.
Victor, you made the trade. You ain't got to tell me why you lost. You won the trade. You don't have to tell me why you lost.
I don't think there's a winner or loser.
Oh, there is. There's always a winner or loser. Always.
If there is ever a point where, how do I say this? If there's ever a point when Lamar Jackson goes absolutely bananas and he's winning games for Nick, which I think he will do, and Nick gets into playoffs, I think that's a negative for me because I do not want to see Lamar Jackson in the playoffs. Derrick Henry, for me, I already told this, standard league, running backs are king. That's the reason I prefer them. But I think if you look at the landscape at the quarterback position, we just talked about how this is the get-right game for Goff and Rodgers. You picked up Kyle Allen. It's because there's not something that you're comfortable with putting out there every week, except for Patrick Mahomes and Lamar Jackson. And those are number one and number two quarterbacks. The number three quarterback is Dak Prescott, who has probably faced Miami Dolphins. Well, he has played Miami Dolphins, New York Giants, and the Washington Redskins, probably the three worst teams in the NFL right now. So I think that them two, Patrick Mahomes and Lamar Jackson, about to separate themselves from the rest of the pack. And we've seen what a quarterback, if you have one of the top quarterbacks in this league, can do. And that's when you have a championship. If you look at the history of it, Terrence won it whenever Matt Ryan was number one quarterback. Last year, Pat Mahomes got him a championship. When Aaron Rodgers was the number one quarterback, he got Nikola Tufa a championship. So I think history is kind of telling. If you have the top quarterback, you will win. Even though, unfortunately, Pat Mahomes is probably going to be that guy again. I don't know how he did it, but he's going to be better than what he was last year.
So let's put this in perspective. So I picked up Kyle Allen for a dollar. I don't even know if it took a dollar. I don't think anybody else bid on it. I took him for a dollar. I would take a side bet at this point, right now, that Kyle Allen, I guess assuming the bet would only be valid if Cam ended up getting surgery on the Liz Frank surgery, whatever, and Kyle Allen played the rest of this year, I'd be tempted, if you'd give me 2-1, 3-1 odds on $20, I'd take Kyle Allen scoring more points than Lamar Jackson.
That's I mean, last week he played Arizona though.
Okay. They're still an NFL football team. Kyle Allen scored 24 points. Lamar Jackson came out 21. I got a three point lead.
Not everyone's going to play Arizona.
I don't disagree, but if you look at Kyle Allen's going forward, he's got Houston. He's got Jacksonville, up and down, maybe. Tampa Bay, then a bye. San Francisco, Tennessee, Green Bay. It's not like Carolina won their division last year and they're playing a number one schedule. I mean, call me crazy, but that side bet's out there for who'd you trade them to? Nick. I'll take it with Nick.
Yeah.
I just don't. I mean, Derrick Henry has got so much more value than Lamar Jackson.
Lamar Jackson has 38 yards less rushing yards than Derrick Henry.
Oh, my God.
It's the points. He's taken 10 more points right now, and I'm just through 3 weeks. Lamar Jackson, 28 points. Derrick Henry, 18 points. 18 points average.
The only two people that want to tell me that Lamar Jackson for Derrick Henry is a good trade is you and Nick. That's it. That's all.
I threw it out there. I've seen the rumblings in the chat. I just went radio silent for a couple days because I'm like, I told Nick, I was like, when we do this, just know it's gonna happen. There's gonna be rumblings. So I was like,
we say this every year, and we make a public announcement on the chat every year. Stop making trades with Victor.
Yeah, and that still holds true. Terrence Ganaway made that rule up.
He didn't make it up. It's a great rule. It's such a great rule. I appreciate that you're in the military. I appreciate the service for our country. But you should go into sales. You really should. You can sell the most crazy bullshit in the world to somebody.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to put our trade discussions out there because I don't want that outside influence to get in your head. But you know that let me help you get better. You winning games is helping me because you're out there fighting that fight too and beating those teams to prevent them from getting the playoffs.
Stop talking to me. I got you winning. You've got you winning. We're moving on. We're going to the next game. Switzer Sweets against Knicks Kicks. I'm sure we'll circle back on this throughout this here at some point or another. Switzer Sweets against Knicks Kicks. Victor, talk me through it. Tell me what you got in the matchup of Chris Powell against Nick Latouf, besides Lamar Jackson.
Oh, yeah, of course. Michael Thomas. He's all over the field going against Dallas defense. Dallas defense ranked 6 in total yards, I believe. That's not what the Cowboys defense is. As a Cowboys fan, they have issues when it comes to defending slot receivers, and it's Michael Thomas being the big guy that he is, and he has that fire in Brandon Cooks. I think that in order for Nick to win, he's going to need Teddy Bridgewater not to throw 172 yards like he did last week. He's going to have to do a lot more down there in New Orleans. And I think that what holds Switzer Sweets back this week is Russell Wilson going to Arizona. I know we just talked about Kyle Allen. I know. But that's not who the Seattle Seahawks are. The Seattle Seahawks are a run-first team. We already talked about my game, but Chris Carson needs to show the freak up and stop fumbling away my wins.
I hope he puts that shit on the ground.
But with that said, I think that Devontae Adams – for Thursday Night Football, goes for 100 yards, and if not a touchdown, if not gets both. And I thought about looking that up for Vegas prop bets because I think this is when Devontae Adams becomes what he was drafted in the second round for, and that's getting Chris a win. Sorry, Nick. You just got to keep building on that trade.
Oh, yeah. I would really like to see Chris flex Wayne Gallman over McLaurin, in my opinion. But I don't know that changes a whole lot. Nick needs Lamar Jackson to be Kyle Allen from last week to have a chance. here. I don't think Michael Thomas. I mean, I think Dallas's secondary is well good enough to stop Michael Thomas. I mean, they hit Michael Thomas for 5 yards here and there. You can't do anything about that. I just don't think Nick's got enough. I think Chris's team is very good from top to bottom. A little more dependent on Green Bay than I would like to be this year. 3 years ago, if he had Green Bay's running back and Green Bay's top wide receiver, you'd just make you, your head would explode because you couldn't understand how he got both of those guys. But I think he wins.
And this is a division game.
I think he wins. I don't think Nick's got enough. For the record, I don't know if he'd have had enough with Derrick Henry either. I think Chris gets it done this week. I think Mr. Powell moves to 3-1.
And it takes control of the North Division.
Takes control. And we all know what happens when Chris Powell takes control.
Yeah.
Moving on, the undefeated Mr. Mike Green against Joe Tiger. This is a close one. It's a good matchup, in my opinion. I'll jump out there, run with it. I'll tell you, I like Mike. He's got the number one running back in the league right now. He's got Dak Prescott, which I expect to play well against New Orleans, even in New Orleans. Doesn't really scare me to go to New Orleans. Frank Gore has played well. New England's defense is really friggin' good, so that could present some sort of a matchup problem, but I think he's ultimately got enough. Amari Cooper, Cooper Kupp, Marvin Jones Jr. played well last week. Does he do that again? Maybe, maybe not. Detroit's a little hot and cold, so that could be a down spot for Mike, but I don't necessarily think that Thielen, Keenan Allen, even though Keenan Allen's the number one wide receiver going right now, I don't think that the wide receivers that he's got, which is the strong point of Tiger's team, I don't think that the wide receivers he's got is going to be enough to take down Mike Green. But on a side note, I would like to compliment Joe Tiger in that I sent him a trade and he responded, messaged me back, and I just respond, people. Just respond. If I send you a trade, say something. Don't just makes me insane. Anyway, I'm sorry, Tiger. I got Joe taking the L here, but thank you for responding to any communication whatsoever. But I got Mike Green. What do you think, Vic?
Yeah, I think you hit nail on the head on that one. Tiger, I want to pitch something to Tiger. Flex Justin Jackson. No, don't even flex. Take out Jamal Williams out of that Thursday night and put in Justin Jackson if he wants a shot at this. He's got to swing for the fences. We're just seeing what Zeke and Pollard did to Miami defense. I think this is a good chance for Justin Jackson to get in the end zone. And that's what he needs to win this game, or else he will lose this game. So as of right now, I'm going to go ahead and swing for it. I'm going to take Ertz so good. And that's because Minnesota and Chicago's matchup, I think that's going to be a back and forth. It's one of those, like, time's going to run out before they can actually maximize their points, if that makes sense. It's not going to be a whole bunch of, like, passes off like that against end zone, flashy. It's just going to be a hard round and pound. Madison's probably going to get involved here. Dak Prescott, I think, faced a huge challenge this week. So I am going to go with Ertz so good, but if he really wants to pull this out, and I'm thinking he should pull Jamal, and I'm not trying to set his line up. I'm just giving him advice. That's what we're doing this show for. And I think he should put in Justin Jackson to get this win. So I'm going to go with him. And this, as well, it's another division game, and this for division lead in the East Division.
Next game we've got is Billy Luna, the Hood Rats, against Slicing Geist. I'm getting better saying that name, by the way. I'd like that to be on the record. Jason Sprayberry. It is our fifth matchup of the week, which, if you're paying attention at home, that makes Mark Woods and John Hodges the game of the week. We'll get to that shortly. Slicing Geist against the Hood Rats, V-Rod. Tell me what your thoughts are.
I have the Hood Rats winning this one.
Me too.
Slicing Geist put in $20 for Case Keenum. Case Keenum didn't even practice today. So that's kind of tell you that direction that he's going.
I understand why these people don't want to do real money on the free agent auction because...
Yeah.
Because they like to spend that shit because it's fake.
Yeah. And, yeah, I wish we could do that. Fortunately, I didn't get it. But I don't think that Slice and Dice has enough to overcome Philip Rivers versus Miami. Todd Gurley has been a disappointment for the Hood Rats. And I think I gave someone these numbers earlier. He only has eight receiving yards through the first three games, which last year he had 64 catches. He's going to overpower it just because the lack of talent that Slicing Guys has. Case Keenum, crazy.
Yeah, Billy's got too much. He puts James Conner in the lineup.
Against Cincinnati. Why does Mike Green make this straight with James Conner going against Cincinnati? At least wait after this week.
Again, we'll let Mike explain that, but yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I do like that Sprayberry got Will Dissly. I think Will Dissly's underrated. Oh, yeah. He's a top five tight end right now. Russell Wilson ain't got shit else. So Will Dissly is a good pickup for Sprayberry. I like that. Smith-Schuster's value is so far diminished without Big Ben, in my opinion. I feel like that about a lot of guys. Like I said, Michael Thomas, value diminished with Teddy Bridgewater. It's going to be a long, long week for Slicing Guys. I think Billy's going to probably put it on him pretty good. It wouldn't bother me if I was pleasantly surprised and incorrect, but I do think Billy gets a W here, gets his first win, gets to 1-3, puts Sprayberry to 1-3. So I'm praying to God for a win here, so that would help. God, that'd make me feel so much better. But I got Billy winning. Maybe call it that. I just want Billy to win. I don't know, but I think Billy pulls away with it. So that's bringing us to Mark Woods against John Hodges, the game of the week. It's a close one. It's going to be a tight one, in my opinion. I like Mark Woods here. I like Daniel Jones going against Washington. He played well last week. He's got Washington. Fun fact for everybody at home, everybody plays well against Washington. So Alvin Kamara is Alvin friggin' Kamara. Marlon Mack's got Oakland. Julian Edelman's got Buffalo. Name somebody in Mark's lineup that doesn't have a good matchup. I think Mark gets it done. Part of me wonders. I mean, Hodges' team he's 2-1. He's won the games in front of him. Part of me can't figure out how. He's got Mark Ingram. Great, great play. Deshaun Watson, meh. DeAndre Hopkins, if Watson's not playing well, Hopkins is okay. James White, Larry Fitzgerald, Greg Olsen. I mean, he's not really exactly lighting the world on fire. He's got a bunch of guys that are going to retire next year from the NFL. I don't know. But he's won the games in front of him. I'm taking Mark. Mark's getting a W this week.
Oh, man. And Mark, his record says 0-3. Mark's not an 0-3 team. Despite what that record says, in week one, he was second highest score. And then... I just don't know what happened, but you are right, and I'm going to take John on this matchup, and the reason being is because I just think that his ceiling is so much higher than what Mark's ceiling is. You're right, everything is about the matchups on Mark's side is very beneficial to him, but I think that the caliber of players that John has an extra ump in it. And I think that this is going to be like one of those. This can be 1-2 in the highest scoring this week. And that's why it's the game of the week. It's because there's so much that can happen in this matchup. I think the Buffalo game is actually I don't think the Patriots get more than 20 points in this game. I think this one is for the AFC East. And they know each other pretty well. And then it's in Buffalo. They're going to try and play Buffalo's game, which is keep Tom Brady off the field. Edelman's been limited in practice with his chest injury, so if he gets one shot to the chest, he's probably sitting out the rest of the game. And then, lo and behold, Josh Gordon here has come for the rescue. And then going against Jaren, who, and going on my rant, but Jaren's last in scoring. And if he keeps that up, it's a person that's finished last in scoring after four games, didn't make the playoffs. So I think that John is going to win this one. And then straight cash home, it goes 0-4, and oh God, he's thinking about next year.
That would be insane.
I would love it. I get $50 for winning division.
No.
And then I play Mark next week, put him 0-5. It's going to be great.
Oh, God. The last thing you want is for Mark to go into next week 0-5.
He's gone radio silent. He posts his little CBS and Yahoo little stuff here and there. I think his last one was about, I don't know, some sad story, and that's what his team is. It's just a sad story. It's kind of like you last year. You had Kamara and McCaffrey. And...
oh, fuck, dude. My team was so good last year.
I don't understand. Oh, I keep going to that just because it's something freaking believable.
Let's call Mark's team this week. If he's silent, he is silent but deadly. He's coming. He's coming for John Hodges. He's getting the W this week against John Hodges. Well, that's what we've got for you. Episode 29, 3.4. That puts a final exclamation point on the week. Enjoy the games tonight, guys. It is Thursday Night Football. Philly against Green Bay? Green Bay.
It is. Green Bay. And Green Bay, too. Lambeau Field.
That'll be a fun one. It'll be a good one to watch. Oh, yeah. Packers all day. Man, seeing Philly lose last week was so awesome. So awesome. All right, well, Victor, what do you got, last words?
League dues are due on Monday, $110. That $10 is for that Week 17 best ball matchup. So if y'all don't understand, it's essentially the team you drafted in Week 17. You don't have to set a lineup. Just going to take whatever your best players are. That's going to be your starting lineup, so... you don't have to worry. I'll explain more than that as we get closer to it. But that's what the league decided on, and that's what that is too. It kind of rewards the best drafter.
So maybe Melvin Gordon will win me some money after all.
Maybe he will.
Well, last word here. I still can't believe that somebody traded Derrick Henry for Lamar Jackson. That's all I got. We'll see you guys. Best of luck to everybody. Unless you traded Derrick Henry for Lamar Jackson – or if you're playing, the genitals are the franchise. Other than that, best of luck to you. We'll see you guys next week. Hope you enjoyed. Like, comment, share. Tell us what you want to see next week. We appreciate you guys watching, and we will see you on the field. LD, a.k.a. the independent variable. Trip good, I'm observing out the hallway. Just to flex on them, we ain't really gotta lie, yeah. I'm a type of motherfucker that'll check the check, do the math, I ain't never getting robbed. Those margaritas not going on my card. I ain't about to split a damn thing for